Joanne C.
Poor reception by Goheng.
Joanne C. firing. Over-received. Great block by UST Ortiz. Again, middle hit. Ortiz has been such a huge factor for UST.
And again, you know, we just have to point out na single block na naman yan. If you look at that, it's only Maranyo blocking her in the middle when it should have been a double block from Lasal.
Tigresses establishing their biggest lead of the match. 2 points. C.
Joanne C.
Joanne C earns her first point. And, you know, this is what we are saying. With the lineup of Lasal, malalim yung bench nila. Joanne C had to, you know, give way to Captain Michelle Gumabaw. Pero alam natin na pagka sumama yung laro ni Gumabaw, meron pa silang
hugot, ano?
Joanne C.
Caballero. Esperanza Chacruz. The tip. Better coverage by UST.
Oh, good
save. What a save by Judy Caballero. Underhand set. Caballero.
Oh, she has the right thing in mind. We saw that open area. Wala coverage, but kinulang.
That lead of UST. Short-lived. We are tied. 11-all. And also one set apiece, Joanne C. serving. Bibilip ka rin dito kay Joanne C. Ano, as you see Caballero getting blocked by Esperanza. Kahit na nakabangko siya for a long time, quick insertion, nag-deliver agad, ano? Chacruz with an error there. Lasal is down by one again.
And that's the right mindset, no? If you're a second stringer, be it from any team, kailangan pag pinasok ka yung pressure, you've already warmed up.
That's true.
And yun yung malaking pressure doon.
Set by the libero. Easy over for Lasal. The tip by Dimakulangan. Chacruz. Off-speed hit. Ortiz tipping it over.
Series of drop balls.
Caballero. Wala nang drop for Caballero. She knocks it down. 13-11, back to a two-point lead, the biggest lead of the Tigresses in the match. Chance of gold Tigers ringing inside the arena in San Juan. Packed venue for the final game of the eliminations. Poor first ball. Maranyo has to make do with that. Caballero. Maranyo. Maranyo's been checked. Here in set number three, Caballero tries again.
Yes! He managed to have a double block, but the timing this time around is off.
14-11, the biggest lead of USD in the match at 3 points. And a timeout by Lasal. Let's listen to Coach Ramil. Lasal down by three for the first time against USD this entire season.
All over the arena.
Gonzalez overkicking that serve.
Well, USD is still up by 2 points. And it's this rotation where they managed to pull away from Lasal at C.
Oh, Caballero is this time on fire.
Yeah, of course, in her comfort zone. Outside, yan ang paborito niya, no? Yung set na mataas. The left side of the court.
Steep serve from Ortiz. Mercado looking for that opening in the middle for UST. Isle, everything going right for the Tigresses. 16-12, the biggest lead of USD over La Salle. They're up by four. Courtesy of the hitting of Judy Caballero. She has delivered, in my opinion, unofficially about 4 points here in set number three.
And This is just what they need. Kanina nakita natin, it was all Isa Maizo. At hindi kinakaya na ganun. But in the second set, we saw Maruba Natigla. Now, Judy Caballero also contributing. And, you know, it's just doing the team very well.
Keeping La Salle, the defense guessing, you know, but this time around, medyo nagkatinginan sila. Giving a 3 point to La Salle, but it's still a 3 point advantage for the defending champions. Good judgment by Gonzalez. She was just a split second away from catching that ball, but she let it go. Service error for La Salle. Back to a 4 point advantage for the Tigresses.
Remember, the second set actually ended with service errors.
Free ball, UST. Banatikla this time. Good coverage behind the hitters for UST. Maizo blocked. Maizo at the net. Esperanza to serve. And this is where USD needs to be very, very careful, because every time Esperanza serves, La Salle is able to make a run.
That's right.
In the front for La Salle,
that's an ace.
There's C, Mercado, and Alarca. And it doesn't help USD's cause that Esperanza gets a service ace.
That's right. Medyo mahirap kasi basahin ang service ni Esperanza. Just like that previous ace where they thought it was already sailing out.
So 2 points quickly for La Salle. Banatikla.
Oh!
Halts that run.
Now you can feel and see the aggressiveness of the USD offense.
Is it a case, Anne, of the blocking of La Salle not as perfect as they want it to be, or is USD just hitting a lot better?
I think USD is hitting a lot better. They are definitely more aggressive, and there are more variations in their shots.
Mercado firing one in. What a missile that was. Two-point deficit for Steph Mercado and the Lady Spikers. Good first ball. Banatikla with the closer.
Look at that. Now she already knows the technique to get the ball through the blockers of La Salle.
And what's good for USD is two players aside from Isa Maizo are bubbling with confidence. That's Caballero and Banatikla.
And of course, Ortiz has also had her yung mga points in the middle.
And even the easy balls para sa La Salle, they can't close it out.
Nakakagulo yung La Salle actually. I think at this point, yung La Salle nagmamadali. They're a bit wary already with the lead that USD has. To the point that parang meron ng nagmamadali na sila sa loob, and there's a bit of tension.
Oh, but Joanne C establishes calm in the middle of all the riot in the offense of La Salle. 3 point deficit for La Salle, 17 serving 20. One set apiece, set number three. Banatikla.
Oh,
Maraño. Basically a free ball for USD here.
And Ortiz connects again.
And there's the whole team of USD now connecting with the setter. Getting themselves some points.
Banatikla.
And it seems that the insertion of Gonzalez, although albeit much, much smaller, then Hirotsuhi has reaped benefits for USD. Good defense. Ball still alive. Eyes up, eyes up. A little too eager that time. Ang gigil ng konti.
I apologize for that one, but I think with how much she has scored in today's game, that can be forgiven.
You can give her one or two of those for sure every set because of how much she delivers. Ooh, costly error on the part of Joanne C.
Si Coach Ramin, nakikita ko on the sidelines, napapailing na lang with the errors that he is seeing from the Lady Spikers.
And usually, palagi nakaupo yan si Coach Ramin, pero ngayon, has been on his feet. Another poor reception from Gohing. This will be an easy over for LaSalle. USD looking for a 5-point lead. There it is. LaSalle's biggest lead over, or make that USD's biggest lead over LaSalle in this season. A 5-point advantage, 23-18. What a shot from Ortiz.
Pero ito yung mga nasasayang na plays. Ano? Melissa Gohing has had quite a few reception errors, and that takes away the chance for them to execute a good play. Look at that. Malayo sa setter, so nawawala sila dun sa play na dapat ginagawa nila.
That's true. Gonzalez picks it up. Set up for Caballero. She loses the joust, but there is a violation on LaSalle. It is set point USD. And folks watching on TV and here at the arena, you are seeing LaSalle for the first time threatened to be down 2-1 this season.
That's right. But you know, before this game, LaSalle actually had a 7-game winning streak, all of which I believe are...
And it is complete. And LaSalle, we're finally seeing them losing two sets in a match for the first time this season. And who better to deliver that than the defending champions, you know?
That's right. And of course, USD, this is what you like about this team. Nandiyan talaga yung attitude and the determination to win against a team like LaSalle.
But of course, you cannot discount LaSalle. They will come back, and we will come back with set number 4 right after these.